You're watching Western Athletic Conference Hoops on ESPN+. Tonight, inside Moody Coliseum, it's the Antelopes of Grand Canyon University in town taking on the Abilene Christian Wildcats. And we welcome you inside Moody Coliseum. Chris Jarrett, Sierra Henry, happy to be along with you for the entire action tonight. Sierra, these are two really good teams, both towards the top of the WAC standings. For Grand Canyon, they've protected the road really well this season, and they're looking to do that tonight.
Absolutely, and last time, you know, the Antelopes beat the Wildcats, and so I think the Wildcats are looking to get their lick back tonight.
And then you're looking at the standings coming into this matchup. We talked about it, two really good teams atop the WAC. For Grand Canyon, they were picked the favorite, Sierra, coming into this. California Baptist enjoying a really nice start to the year as well, but GCU continuing to be a tough opponent atop the WAC.
And Abilene is already defeating the odds. You know, moving up in the fourth, they were picked to finish fifth, so they're already beating the odds here.
Let's look at the impact players tonight coming into this matchup. Sierra, let's start first with Grand Canyon. For Nadia Evans, you can see how she shoots it from the field, her outage as well in a minutes per night. She's really versatile.
Yeah, she's one of the best three-point shooters in the country. She's ranking at 32nd in three-point percentage. She's first in the WAC in that category, along with first in total three-pointers made. You know, she's a shooter. She's got a shooter in the house.
Then we're going to stack up Addison Martin for the Wildcats tonight, Sierra. I think they've got to be big inside, and they're going to lean on the redshirt sophomore in Addison Martin. Seven games this season, above 40% shooting from the field, and six of those games she spent time in double figures scoring. So Martin, the size for the Wildcats, looking to be a big factor tonight. We're happy to be with you on ESPN Plus for the Loops of Grand Canyon and the Wildcats of Abilene Christian. ACU coming in 6-6 and 2-1 in conference play. And Grand Canyon at 12-3 and 4-0 overall in the WAC. In the black road jerseys tonight, ACU and the home whites toss it up. Let's go. And the Wildcats win down the opening tip. The starting five of Traeger, Earl with it now, hole. Thornton will let an early three fly, no good. And Addison Martin inside, second chance points up and good. Sierra Henry, we talked to Molly Miller, the head coach for Grand Canyon, said we have to limit the second chances.
Yes, she said it's absolutely important that they get in there and rebound and block out.
In the opening 30 seconds to the Wildcats, Grand Canyon's first touch of the night. They go in the near corner, now skip it long side, three, up and down for Nadia Evans. We talked about it pregame of what she can do beyond the arc.
Absolutely, she's that three-point shooter, and like we said, she's coming out hot.
Checking all the boxes of our pregame prep, and it's Grand Canyon in front early by a narrow point. Chris Jarrett and Sierra Henry with you on ESPN+. As hoops are back inside Moody Coliseum. A little miscommunication there, and a turnover gives it back to the Lopes. They'll look to run. Transition, there's Evans.
There again, and that's exactly what they do, is force turnovers.
Another three look, no good. And the board pulled down by Earl. Shot wouldn't go. Grand Canyon, a team from three that shoots it at 36%, but they defend the arc really well. Opponents just shooting it at 30%. No Aspen Thornton last game against UT Rio Grande Valley. She's back and they're happy about it. Bella Earl, really contested look there, Sierra.
Yeah, she's tough. She's gonna get in there and try to draw the foul, but she didn't get it this time.
Stripped away on the near side. It's gonna stay right here. Grand Canyon, the WAC preseason favorites. They received six votes to Southern Utah's five.
And there she is.
Pretty easy on the inbound pass, just flashed on the baseline and she was wide open.
Yeah, she could have had the reverse layup right there.
This is where Abilene Christian will look to force the Lopes to work for it. It's the half court game and they draw the turnover. Peyton Hole all alone, got it.
Listen, there's a reason why she's three times newcomer of the year. She's not scared to get in there and finish it.
They like the freshman 10 in white for ACU and Peyton Hole. Skip pass, and now work back up top. Long skip back to Evans, who's got GCU's lone three, and another turnover. Thornton takes it coast to coast, and the foul got it. How about that for a quick start?
Yeah,
turnover to points on the other end.
And that's what they've got to be careful of. Turnovers turning into points is gonna kill them.
And there's the head coach for ACU and Julie Goodenough, 12 seasons. And that's the top one, I think, the most important, no losing campaigns in her time in Abilene, Texas.
Yeah, and she said, you know, they take a lot of pride in playing at home, so they're looking to really put on for the city tonight in front of the home crowd.
We mentioned Aspen Thornton back in the rotation. She shoots at 71% from the stripe. Just 1-for-3 in 26 minutes against Louisiana Tech. Again, ACU's last home game all the way back in December 30th. Open three look, good from the far corner. Up and down for Eric Strupp.
And there, her and her sister had a pretty hot game a couple games ago, and so they're really showing up. Well, she's showing up right now.
And a turnover will give it back to Grand Canyon. Sydney Eric Strupp, who knocked it down, the transfer from Arizona State. As Sierra mentioned, twin sister Laura Eric Strupp, transfer from San Diego. Brought up the floor by Jada Holland. Now back to her. And skip back to Eric Strupp. She'll let another one fly. Good. 2-for-2 from beyond the arc, and the Lopes have their first lead of the night.
They do not play around when it comes to shooting those threes. You know, GCU's Molly said that they got to blind the three, but it's looking like ACU needs to blind that three.
It was 7-3, albeit early. That's how much of a difference that three can impact a game. Hull will look to drive left side, draws the help, and a tip pass. Still loose, and Traeger keeps it alive. Wildcats, for the moment, the advantage. They'll boot it to Traeger, open three, front rimmed it. And a loose board pulled in by Olivia Lane. She's good for about 6 a night, and there's number one. Eric Strupp lets the third go, left it short. Peyton Hole pulls down the rebound. If you've made your last two, you gotta let that third go.
Yeah, she's not letting up. They better find a way to put a hand up.
And Thornton takes it coast to coast. We're all knotted up at nines. About 4 minutes gone by. It's been a lot of up and down.
And a 6-1 guard, you know, in women's basketball, I mean, that's, even if you put a hand up, I don't know if that can stop her.
A lot of size that she'll use. Eric Strupp, three affected. Earl caught a stray.
Rebounding.
And a second chance point up and down for Olivia Lane. 6'2 forward transfer from North Dakota, and that'll be a common denominator is how many transfers this team has in Grand Canyon. They pieced together a really impressive lineup. And Hole looking for Earl up top. And that's what ACU looks to avoid, are those turnovers that gives it right back to the opponent.
You know, for GCU to kind of piece together two twin sisters that were not going to the same school, you know, you get some type of telepathy going on, probably if they're on the court at the same time.
Turnovers is what Grand Canyon loves to force. 18 the last time out, forced. Lane takes it hard left side, no good, and Traeger pulls down the rebound. Early going so far with Grand Canyon shooting it 50% from the stripe. Ball goes out of bounds. There's Molly Miller in her fourth season, formerly Drury University Panther head coach. And how strong were they in that time from 2014 to 2020? A 180-17 record for Miller as the Wildcats able to knot it back up at 11. Swung back up top. Drive now by Holland, picks her dribble up. Boots it back up top, quick pass underneath Lane, able to finish.
They are gonna have to get inside, and GCU's got a lot of size on them right now on the court, and they're gonna have to get in there and put a hand up.
And this is not hard full court pressure, just a soft look to try and throw ACU off. They clear it easily, but 10 seconds burned on the shot clock. Now down to 15 as Hole boots it up top. Earl lets a three go. Left off the mark, tipped out of bounds, and it'll stay on the end with ACU as we head to our first media timeout of the night. Lopes on the road out in front of the home Wildcats by 2.
WAC Vegas is back. The best fans, championship basketball, all in exciting Las Vegas. Join us March 13th through the 16th at the Orleans Arena for the 2024 Hercules Tires WAC Basketball Tournament. Don't miss the crowning of a men's and women's champion. more information, go to waxsports.com/WaxVegas.
Back inside Moody Coliseum after our first media stoppage. Let's look at tonight's keys to the game first. Chris Jarrett, Sierra Henry back with you. Sierra, looking at both of these keys, you see transition game, a common denominator there. Both these teams really have to move after misses and looking to push it up the floor.
Absolutely, because both teams will stop at that three-point line and pop it. So, you know, they're both going to have to get back on defense and do it fast and find their men early.
And in transition, GCU wants to work inside out. They want the penetration, boot it to the outside, open three. ACU, more of the same. They have to knock down their open looks. They've done that, but 0 for 3 to start beyond the arc.
Absolutely. Molly said the philosophy on penetration is going to need to be tight, and it's going to be the same way on Abilene Christian's side, too.
And so Thornton will let one go. Front rimmed, chases her own shot. And now we'll reset. Wanted a pull again. Turnaround shot up and down for Addison Martin.
Yeah, she was looking for the handoff, but she turned around and said, hey, I'm open. Let me go ahead and take it.
Little elbow mid-range. She knocked it down. The freshman Emma Troxell and Gracie Wernley new into the match for ACU. They really like their freshmen that are new in town. And a nice drive by Evans. Kicks it back out. Open three look. Off the mark. Loose underneath, and Lane pulls it down. Back with Evans, 15 on the timer, and they'll hit the reset button. Cooper passes it off. Simons driving hard, left side off the window, no good, but draws the contact and sends the Lopes to the free throw line for the first time tonight. This is Troxell maybe looking for the help from Martin, who never really stepped in there, and Troxell had to kind of compensate, had the physicality.
Yeah, you can't be scared to get in there, and that's one thing that Molly Miller coaches is toughness and not being afraid to get in that paint and get hit, bumped a little.
So Lane earns a breather, 2 for 3 from the field and 3 boards. First free throws up and down for Simons. Shoots at 60% at the stripe as Troxell had it knocked out of her hands. And able to find Bella Earl in transition, being chased by Cooper, transfer from UC Santa Barbara. A little over 3 minutes to go in quarter number one. Lopes on top by a point, and a foul a long ways away from the hoop, but that's good on Cooper contesting Thornton, not giving her a lot of space to breathe.
Yeah, they're saying that she's a ball hawk. You know, she's great on defense, and that's what they've got her in here for, is to defend that perimeter.
Martin goes high window, no. Earl has to rip down the rebound and get rid of it quickly. Wernley, the freshman, no. Back to Earl. Finds Wernley, she'll pull for three, got it. The first triple of the night. And it's the freshman Gracie Wernley giving ACU the lead.
And you can see Coach Miller saying, hey, what have I told you guys? You gotta blind the three.
It's a GCU team with no Trinity San Antonio. It's one of the players that we were looking at coming into this match. Cooper, a tough drive, left it short. San Antonio, an all-WAC first teamer.
Yeah, you know, she's only, 199 points of reaching her 1,000 points. So
it's incredible.
This game is going to be a little detrimental to her getting to that 1,000 point.
This was... Wernley, inside the paint, was able to float back out there, and a nice find from Bella Earl. And again, the first triple of the night to go down for ACU. Prior to, they were 0 for 4. Grand Canyon has sat at 3 for 6. And it's Sydney Erickstra, the grad student, with two of them. Skip pass in the far corner, back to Erickstra, denied by Troxell. Inside, and a walk. Laura Erickstra trying to fight for position, but she shuffled the feet.
Got to plant those feet and really go up strong with those moves.
Wernley will work it across the stripe. Thornton with it with over 2 minutes to go in quarter number one. Wildcats a chance to build on the lead and a tight contest by Martin. A little too physical by Laura Erickstrup working around and denying the pass.
Yeah, she got on the wrong side of her there and she saw that. You know, if she gets that drop step, it's over. So It's like, do I foul or do I let the shot go?
It's the right idea to try and slide around and deny, but yeah, there's a lot of open court behind her. Thornton with it. Working on Osley off the window, no. Tipped underneath, ball still loose and poked around. And it's on the floor, it'll draw to a tie-up. The possession arrow belongs to Grand Canyon.
These girls are scrappy, and that's what you love to see in a good women's basketball game. Is they're going for every ball, every loose ball, every rebound. Love to see it.
That's how Molly Miller described ACU coming into this. This is a scrappy team. They're going to try to fight for second chance points, offensive boards, try and turn you over, especially in their home gym. They want to make you uncomfortable and try and do anything they can to gain the upper hand. Holland takes it across half court, transfer from San Jose State. Eric Strupp works it around. Evans driving inside. Nice little spot up jumper, no. And Eric Strupp a bit too early on the rebound attempt. Pulled down by ACU. Minute and a half to go in the first quarter. Troxel denied. And too physical. This time it was Sydney Erickstra trying to deny.
Yeah, and they are doing exactly what they should be doing. Keep going there because she is having problems defending her, and they're going to get her in foul trouble. And before you know it, she's going to have to sit out for a little bit.
Four fouls for the Lopes. So the Wildcats shooting free throws. Next whistle. Meredith Mays into the contest for ACU. Looking for the fellow freshman Troxel. She finds other fellow freshman Warnley. Thornton with it, inside out. Hole thought about it, but couldn't get a dribble down in time.
And that's what happens when you're in a fast game sometimes. It's like you want to make the move before you even know what you're committing to.
Might have had a window to get that up, but Eric Strupp was there with the tall hand. Shot underneath by Holland, no good. Now the Wildcats running. Hole in that spot, she likes that spot, but not given any space by Evans. Troxel up top, floats it to Mays. Under a minute to go in the first quarter. Thornton wrapping around, loose underneath, and lost it. Still loose, and that'll draw the tie up. That's smart on Meredith Mays. The possession arrow belongs to ACU. Didn't want to give Grand Canyon just a free possession swap. It looked like it was free right there, but Mays just comes in and ties it up. Warnley the inbounder, up top to hole. Eric Strupp stands her ground and bumped hole off balance. Molly Miller doesn't like it. That'll be free throws now for the Wildcats for the final half minute.
Eric Strupp is gonna have to do some adjustment with her defense and getting to move her feet so she's not bumping and hitting. She's definitely getting into a little foul trouble here.
Yeah, that's number two. Sydney Erickstrup, she'll check out. That's tough because she's knocked down two of the three three-pointers tonight.
And that's exactly what Abilene Christian wants, is to sit her down for a little bit so they can take advantage of that.
Hole sinks them both, and a four-point lead for ACU. Foul trouble, something that Coach Miller will have to try to adjust to as the game winds on. Lopes certainly have the depth. Loaded up top for the final 25 of the first quarter. Evans going baseline on hole. Skips it out, Osley open three. Off the mark, rebound underneath, up and good. Second chance for Laura Erickstrup, and she knocks it down. Clock running, 10 seconds to go in the quarter. The Wildcats with some confusion on the inbounder, now down to five. Thornton in trouble. Clock stops with just 7/10 of a second left. And so good enough for ACU. We'll get Earl and Martin into the contest for some size. I don't know, 0.7 seconds. Not a whole lot of time to try and catch and shoot. Floats it to Martin. And a turnover, so that'll give it back to Grand Canyon.
And when we talked to Coach Miller yesterday, and I was like, who do you think is going to pop out this game? And Laura Erickstrup was one of her pop-out players, but she did say, you know, our bench is deep. So, you know, up next could be Olivia Lane, Shay Faino. We'll see.
They're going to need that depth with early foul trouble for Grand Canyon on the road. It's a two-point lead for the Wildcats as we step aside. Second quarter coming your way next on ESPN+. Back to Abilene, Texas, in a two-point lead for the home Wildcats. Fresh 10 minutes up on the clock, and we're ready to roll in quarter number two. Chris Jarrett, Sierra Henry, our entire ACUTV crew, happy to be with you on this Thursday night. Writing a new chapter in 2024. Evans with it up high, picks her dribble up and is in trouble.
And Abilene's all over.
There's an offensive foul to send it back the other way. I'll give it back to ACU, and that's really the trend that we were on, Sierra, in the first quarter was foul trouble, trying to limit instances like this to give it back to ACU.
Absolutely, and then it's like you get right back in, tip of the second quarter, and fouling again.
Yeah. That'll go on Laura Erickstrup. That's number two. Sydney's on the bench with two as well. Wildcats weren't shooting free throws for a lot of the first quarter, but they did get to number five. Traeger missed a look underneath and now has to run back. The Lopes looking to push the tempo. Up top, it's Evans. Gashing inside, back to Osley up top. What a long, couple long breaks in the first quarter with no stoppages.
Oh.
And that one sailed. Miscommunication by Holland. But we mentioned earlier, too, turnovers were something that Grand Canyon did not do a lot of. They had eight all game last time out against Utah Tech. That's already number five for the Lopes.
And that's not something they want to see, being that in the last four games, they forced 81 turnovers alone in those last four games. But they don't want to be on the other side of that.
Thornton with it. And loses herself in the end line. Unforced turnovers, something that ACU trying to recognize and do more without. That's number seven tonight already for the Wildcats. Gotta limit the free chances for both opposing teams, both coaches knowing that, recognizing that coming into this one.
And she's got the lane wide open. And
that's all the way for Jada Holland, fifth year guard from Pleasanton, California. We talk about a roster full of transfers. Holland, San Jose State, was at UC Riverside prior to that.
And she had that lane a couple times before, so I think she's finally seeing like, hey, I jab step here and I can go all the way.
Martin one-on-one, boots it out. Hole tries an open three off the mark. Well, they're trying to get the freshman from Peaster going and Peyton Hole.
Gotta be careful of that though, because if you leave her wide open like that, nine times out of 10, she's knocking that down.
Baseline drive, Thornton tried to take it away, open three, Evans airmailed it, and it'll stay on this end of the floor. Tipped out of bounds. Let's take another look. You're talking about the lane for Jada Holland. Yeah, and Martin just was there and then left. And Holland, a little patience, it opened right up. Evans bothered by Traeger. Five on the shot clock. And a kick ball is gonna give a fresh 20.
Was almost gonna be a steal there.
And that's with five on the shot clock too. That gives GCU a full fresh 20. That's a tough break. Worked back up top.
Missed the look there.
You see Shea Fano for the first time tonight, and a nice slicing drive again by Holland. Just working her way around inside the perimeter. She's got the last four for Grand Canyon, and it extends the Lopes lead.
She was another player that Coach Miller talked about having a pop-out game, and looks like she's just getting started right now.
Hole driving, boots it to Thornton. Open three, too strong, and Hole goes over the back. You can see, Sierra, that ACU trying to move the ball and find open threes, but they're just not going down right now.
Absolutely, because they're getting wide open shots, and I'm not sure if that's Coach Miller is a fan of that, being that she's saying, hey, blind the three, find your girl early. Do not let them breathe on that three.
Already 3 minutes gone by in the second quarter. Bono with it up high, guarded by Martin. Hold tightly on Evans. Fading away from the bucket, the shot off the mark. Loose rebound attempt, and Martin will settle it down. It's a good defensive trip for ACU. Evans.
If Fano rolls the other way on that pick and roll, she's wide open, so she's got to figure out that right step.
Martin attacking Fano, boots it out to Earl, and she dragged that pivot foot. Tried to keep it down as long as she could. But another turnover for ACU. Thought maybe that she got beat to that spot by Schraw. That's Asha Schraw, redshirt freshman from Fresno, California. Also seeing her for the first time in tonight's game. In the second quarter, she's got it now at the top of the key. Right in front of the ACU bench. Swings it around, Lane with it. Holland skip pass to Schraw, far corner three. Off the front rim, Wernley has to rip it down and finally comes away with it. That's a freshman pulling that board down.
Absolutely, she had to get in there and scrap for it to deserve that rebound.
Hole's got it up top with 5:45 before halftime. Tipped pass, and it finds Wernley. Martin now drawing the double team. Hole open three, got it! Boy, they needed that one to go down.
Listen, she's gonna knock one down eventually, so you can see Jada Holland rushing out there to make sure she defended that one, but hey, she already had too many open ones, and that one had to go down.
And a switch here with Traeger way up high. Bounce to Lane. Now the Wildcats will reset. Osley with it around the top of the key. Holland working on Traeger. Down to three on the timer. Bumped on the shot, no call. Second chance board by Lane underneath. Back up, Schraw open three. Got it! Offensive board leads to an open three, and it puts the Lopes back on top.
Not bad, not bad for a redshirt freshman.
That ended 2.5 minutes of a scoring drought for Grand Canyon. Hole step back three won't count. Whistles as they flag her for trying to buy some space. That boots us to our media in the second quarter. 4:42 to go before halftime. Grand Canyon fighting on the road. They got a 2-point lead over ACU.
Don't miss the crowning of a men's and women's champion. For more information, go to waxsports.com/waxvegas.
Back inside Moody Coliseum. And hey, listen, the Julie Goodenough Show live your way on Wednesdays, 9 a.m. Central, 10 a.m. Eastern time. Sit down with us as we catch up with the head coach, Julie Goodenough, go through everything with the ACU Women's Hoops program. And again, you can watch live or on demand on ESPN Plus, Wednesdays, 9 a.m. Central. 2-point lead for the Lopes as we inch closer to halftime. Chris Jared, Sierra Henry, ESPN Plus. With our entire ACU TV crew, Sierra, we talked about this game's flying by. There's not really been a lot of whistles. It's been physical, but a lot of up and down.
But I knew this was going to be a really good matchup because they both have a deep bench and they both play a lot of team ball. So it's any given player on any given night. Next man up mentality on both squads.
Molly Miller said that, talking to us prior to this contest, was we've had some sicknesses, we've had some injuries, and we've got to just rotate with what we've got, the roster that we've built. 3-second violation gives it back to the Wildcats, trailing by two.
Listen, those turnovers are racking up, and I know Coach Miller is boiling on the inside.
That's number 7 for Grand Canyon, AC with 9. both teams above average and higher than they'd like. Wernley spots up, open three, knocked down, no call, and we play on. Earl thought she was bumped on the rebound attempt, and with no whistles, it'll go to Grand Canyon. Here's the whole sequence. This is Wernley with it on the fall down. She got the right foot of Wernley, and then on the rebound attempt, Earl had a chance, but it dribbled into the near sideline. So it goes back to Grand Canyon, and no points for ACU on that trip down the floor.
You got a lot of the toughness in these girls because, you know, they're getting knocked down and bumped everywhere, and it's like, I'm just gonna get back up and keep it going.
Good cut, but no finish underneath. Ball still loose. Ossoli with it. And swung back up top. Holland was right inside, but a high hand. She couldn't get a shot to go down. Lane frees herself up, off the window, good. Floated that right over top of Meredith Mays, and a nice finish underneath. That was Schraw with a nice pass to float it over top. Little touch. And Hole on the crossover. Knocks down the three, but after the whistle. Probably would like to just deny the foul and keep the three. There's the finish on the other end. That's Lane that she sat most of the first quarter, had good outage in the first 5 minutes, but then she got a breather. But now 3 for 4 from the field, 3 offensive boards. She's got 4 total.
Another one of those players that Coach Miller listed that could have a pop-out game. I mean, listen, just because they didn't start on this team, you must know that they have potential to start in these games.
Julie Goodenough doing more of the same, rotating her bench in and out, and it's Meredith Mays that heads to the bench. Addison Martin back in. Thornton with it up high, wrapping around, trying to go the whole way, but fouled on the shot attempt, and she left it just short.
Even though we're getting to the free throw line here, you got to finish those buckets in games like this because it's going to come down to the last couple of points.
That was Lane that picks up her second. First one for Thornton is good. That's now 3 lopes with 2 personal fouls. For ACU, they've got some fouls as well that they're keeping track of. Second one for Thornton, back ironed, and Bella Earl runs down the long rebound, floats it back up top. Wildcats will reset. 3 minutes to go before halftime, they trail by 3. Traeger looking for Hole, spots up 3, got it! Tie ball game, the freshman Hole with another triple.
It's crazy because the wide opens when she was missing, I guess she likes the challenge better, it makes her makes her want to drop it down.
Just needs a little bit of a hand in the face, not
right.
Wide open. On the opposite end, a 3-pointer no good. And Hole with the rebound. Pushing the floor, finds Earl. A tie game after a Peyton Hole 3. Back to the freshman. Bumped off balance, stays with it. Aspen Thornton with 10 on the timer. She's got Martin fighting for position underneath. Pull-up jumper, good.
Now that was a play. I mean, she almost had her on a poster.
Just patience. She just had to wait, play things out. That's Hole up high on Holland, wrapping all the way around off the window, good.
And that is what she is good at, is finding that open lane. She is not big in size, but listen, that does not stop her.
Started right about the logo and wrapped all the way around with Hole right on her doorstep. Nice pass underneath from Hole to Traeger, and the foul, count it. Woo.
And cuts like those, you don't see her in here, but she,
right there.
The backdoor cut, yeah, is always magical. I mean.
And the fire from Claire Traeger too. That's what they love about her. Just a spark plug player. You throw on the floor and she can give you a charge. Wildcats bringing Claire Graham in to give Peyton Hole some extended time before halftime with 1:36 on the clock.
Players in the paint love a good backdoor cut.
Traeger makes it a 3-point lead. At 5'10", a listed forward, but she's got a lot of speed, and plays very fast. So one of those stretch four type forward guard players. Holland will reset, calls a play out with 15 on the shot clock. They switch. Right side drive off the window and good. What a finish from Simons, as it looked like it was off to a good start. And then she got picked up. She flipped it off the glass and it goes down.
You gotta just hit it right off that corner and you know it's going in.
Thornton forcing the left side, trying to get to the line, and she does. Just goes right at Jada Holland. That's just Holland's first, so that's a great sign and a matchup that's had some contact so far. Boy, I don't know. First one for Thornton is good. 11 for Aspen Thornton.
Missing her last week, I am not excited to see what that looked like.
It just removed an important cog from the operation, and they have to go and supplement with the bench as best they can. 50 seconds before halftime, and it's ACU by three. Holland working on Graham, stops at the free throw line, boots it out to Evans. 10 on the timer. And a fight underneath. And they're gonna whistle Martin for that. That's Fano trying to fight for position. Yeah, I mean, it's really physical, but it's tough to see on who.
Yeah,
you're
getting
it both ways.
On defense, you've gotta position that foot and the hand in the right spot, or you're in the wrong.
Holland, the inbounder, floats it up to Fano. Evans with it. Looking for options, goes in front of the bench to Schraw. Now Fano working on Graham and fouled on the way up. That's five on the shot clock, but the mismatch underneath, and that's a tough assignment.
Listen, Fano, every time she comes off that screen, she is wide open. If she just gets it right and opens up the right way, she doesn't even have to get a foul. She's wide open.
That's Claire Graham working underneath. She was in great position, but at the last second, trying to get her arm in the works and pry the ball free, wasn't able to do so. And the first free throw attempt clunks out. Fano with 9 minutes in, that's her first trip to the line tonight.
With a presence like Fano, you can't even let her catch the ball. That's a player that you want to play. You need some backside help. One in the front, one in the back.
Yep. Splits the pair, and now, again, a soft full court look. Callie Cooper back in for GCU. Final 15, shot clock turned off before halftime. Earl working in, finds Traeger, had it knocked away, tipped loose, still loose, finds Thornton, she'll hoist it up, and it's off mark. A good look after a scattered possession, but ACU will settle for a 2-point halftime lead. Wildcats with Grand Canyon on the road, heading to the locker room, and both teams with a much deserved breather coming up. Two quarters up and down already from Moody Coliseum. We'll step aside and break down the first half after we take a break ourselves on ESPN Plus. Little over a minute to go before we start half number two between Grand Canyon and Abilene Christian. You see the score there above the top of your screen. It's a close one as we welcome you back courtside inside Moody. Chris Jarrett, Sierra Henry. Sierra, let's talk about what we've seen so far in this first half. Starting first for ACU, we knew that this would be a tough assignment for them to try and protect this home floor. What have you seen so far to give them a 2-point lead early?
I mean, I'm seeing that they're getting out there, they're guarding the ball, they're very scrappy on defense and offense, they're getting second chance plays, they're not letting up.
And that's really what we've seen is that Abilene Christian wins the first quarter, Both teams split the scoring in the second quarter, but it's been a slow start out the gate for ACU from three, but they've been able to knock some threes down. Aspen Thornton you see there, and Peyton Hole, those two have been huge for ACU.
Yes, and they are, and you know, usually it's Bella Earl, but you learn, like we said, they have a deep bench, and they just have a nice duo. Peyton paired with anybody on that team, is, and they get to going, it's hard to stop.
And they've been good so far with what we've seen from ACU. Both Aspen Thornton and Peyton Hole with 12 points combined. Let's look now at Grand Canyon. We mentioned the turnovers are something that they're going to want to try and limit more of. For Abilene Christian, they've been able to cash in on those turnovers as well. So limiting those turnovers and trying to assert their dominance, I think, inside are going to be big for the Loads.
Absolutely. And then limiting those, if we're going to have turnovers, limiting those shots and points off turnovers is going to be big for both teams.
So we start quarter number three inside Moody Coliseum. And it's Abilene Christian on the opening possession. They float one to Traeger. She barely pulls it down. Martin left side off the window. No. Earl chasing it. Has it knocked out of bounds. It'll stay on this end of the floor. A five for ACU of Martin, Earl, Hole, Traeger, and Thornton. The top of your screen in the corner. They get it inside to Martin. Slicing, Traeger has it knocked away, goes into the bench and tried to save it at the last second. Thought that it should stay on that end of the floor, but officials telling Traeger that it must have bounced off the far sideline or she touched it, combination of both. Lopes with it now to start the third quarter. They swing it to the near corner. Evans getting rid of it, laying a nice up and down shot just outside the painted area, and that's where she's been really good so far.
Another one of those players, like we said, you know, they're popping out tonight, and it's exciting to see that those players step up and move into those roles when people are getting into foul trouble.
Both teams trying to get to the paint. Martin will spot up from the jumper. We saw that shot, go down earlier tonight. That time, no good.
Jada rushing in there and getting the rebound is something that Coach Miller is going to love.
And then Lane left all alone, missed it.
Oh, you got to make those.
Yeah. And then a foul underneath. Boy, maybe was expecting contact, but this was a walk-in bucket with how she was left wide open. Called for it, got it. And just maybe stopped playing.
Maybe it just shocked her that they would leave her wide open under the basket like that.
Unfortunate that they retain possession. It's Evans with it up top, bouncing to Holland. Driving paint, no. Tipped around, Lane pulls it down. Off the window, no. How about a third try as Osley gets in there for the O board, and the Lopes will reset. This is where they want to cash in, is on the second and third chance looks. Lane again all alone, off the window, good. Utilizing that size advantage, what we talked about, it's how Grand Canyon will win the second half if they intend to do so, is get that ball inside on offense. Thornton driving off the window, no. Holland pulls it down. Long pass up the floor for Evans. She's got it. Off the window and good. That forces an ACU timeout. A 6-0 run out the gate for Grand Canyon. And that sends us to our first timeout of the second half. 4-point lead for Grand Canyon. They knocked down their first three shots from the field. We'll step aside on ESPN+. Perkins Insurance is thankful for our country's military members. 6-0 run for Grand Canyon to start the first 2 minutes of the second half. Chris Jarrett and Sierra Henry back with you, and it's been Olivia Lane inside, finding a lot of space, and contact as well, and able to finish. Wildcats with it, up four. That's where we resume. Thornton found Hole, who went right back to Aspen Thornton. Meredith Mays fighting inside with Lane. Hole spots up three, in and out. Mays fighting for the board, but it's pulled down by the Lopes. Mm-hmm. And a travel. Mays was just kind of contesting. We'll see the three from Hole. I don't know how it doesn't go down. But then Mays right here just fighting around for the rebound, and it draws the travel underneath by Erickstra.
Listen, when you look up and there's a big body in front of you like that, it does make you want to take an extra step.
Sydney Erichstrup missed a good amount of the first half with foul trouble.
Oh.
Nice slide step by Hull, but she walked. Was trying to slice through traffic and looked like she intended to do just that.
It looked like maybe she was going to go up with it, but then out of her peripheral, she's like, oh, yeah. Someone's wide open.
Just covered a lot of ground on that second step. Looks awkward sometimes. Batted ball as we've seen Grand Canyon a lot skip tonight. Mm-hmm. A lot of passes going over top the defense.
And that's able to jump great that. Basketball yeah. IQ to pay attention to that because she's like, no, ma'am, you're not going to keep tossing that thing over.
Holland takes it all the way. 8-0 run for Grand Canyon to start quarter number three. It's her largest lead of the night.
The way she finds those holes is like she sees it and she's gone.
Thornton with it up top. Hole opened up for three off the mark. Traeger offensive board up and down. That's a big bucket for ACU. Their first of the second half. And it comes how the Lopes wanted to limit the second chance points. Holland slashing through. Earl pulls down the board. This is where ACU was effective in the first half, off of misses pushing the tempo. And now the half-court game. Thornton goes right at the pressure, floats it up top to the freshman hole. Lofts it up in a tough spot for Mays, and out of bounds. Another turnover for ACU. Lopes by four with 4 minutes gone. This was Thornton again, going up top and an open three, no. Second chance points huge for ACU to hang around in this game. They trail by four and a whistle stops play. Grand Canyon shooting it at 46% tonight. ACU at 41. But the Lopes have attempted six more shots and knocked down four of them. A lot of high percentage looks. Underneath, speaking of high percentage looks.
Now that was a nice straight shot pass. I mean, straight to the paint.
Yeah. That's Erichstrup too, trying to pick up where she left off in the first half. Taken out of the game with two personal fouls. Earl, nice pass to Mays, driving through off the window. And draws the foul. This will be tough if it's on Erichstrup, and it is. That's number three.
And you know, the best thing about Earl is even when she's not putting up points, she is still producing points with her teammates, dropping dimes, grabbing rebounds. She still shows up.
You saw the replay of Sydney Erichstrup finishing underneath. Mays, the first one is good. That's what Grand Canyon is electing to keep on the floor, even with three personal fouls. Second one for Mays is good. Back to a four-point game. Meredith Mays just 54% from the stripe, but two big ones that the Wildcats needed. Evans to Holland. Osley bouncing baseline. Erichstrup swings it back up top. Good ball movement as Osley thought about a three. Evans on a ball fake, shot no. Another second chance board underneath and a foul called as Lane trying to pry it down. The ball movement, Evans the three, no, but no body on Lane.
And one thing the Wildcats are gonna have to do is refrain from sending Lane to the free throw line. She's leading their team in free throw makes. So that's what she wants to do, is get to that line.
That's really tough with the size, too. She's the tallest one on the floor right now, standing at 6'2". Native of Minnesota. Plays collegiately at North Dakota before transferring to Grand Canyon, and a look underneath, up and down for McKenna Simons.
And that was a nice little curl cut that she did there to get herself open.
Tipped by Evans, and it forces the Wildcats. Open three for Hull, left it short. Evans picked up quickly by Hull. Holland finds Osley in transition three, around and out. Another old board by Lane. Boots it out, Holland will hit the reset button. Simons up high, screening, Lane with it at the stripe. Out to Holland, three, too strong. Pohl pulls down the board. Grand Canyon pulled away from three. Nice pass to Earl. Contact, and she had to get rid of it with Holland stepping in to draw the charge. Bounce to Simons. Thornton draws the offensive. Up and down, and that sends us into a media. Take a breath. Grand Canyon by six with under 4 minutes to go in the third quarter. Molly Miller was a heck of a player with Drury in her time there. She goes back to coach her alma mater, was there 2014 and 2020, and took them all the way to the 2019 D2 Final Four. Back inside Moody Coliseum, Chris Jarrett, Sierra Henry with you, our entire crew on ESPN Plus on this Thursday night. 12-4 advantage Lopes to start the third quarter.
Coach Miller got one of her players and brought her along as an assistant. She played for at Drury, Deja Bernard.
Looking to duplicate that staff. Now in her fourth season, Kennedy rising out on the floor for ACU. Looking to mix it up a little bit. Freshman Emma Troxel had it lofted to her, but almost, and then eventually taken away. Lopes in transition, attacking. Evans with it up high.
Lane defending the paint. That got Eric Strip in foul trouble.
And it's points in the paint advantage, Lopes 24-16, and make it 26 off the window and goes down for Olivia Lane. She has been money tonight, make her 6-for-9 with 8 boards, and those 12 points as well. High percentage looks and miscommunication by ACU. Saw really good things from the Wildcats in the first half, but this is a very tough Grand Canyon team to play four quarters against.
I think it's just getting frustrating guarding the paint for GCU with ACU. You know, In my opinion, I would think that they need to kind of maybe do a little front side, back side with the post players here.
Wildcats not liking how the turnovers are rising up to 15 now. 8 for the Lopes. Corner three, got it, plus the foul. Up and down for McKenna Simons after the shot goes off. And a smile on the face, but that's a tough limp, hoping she can stay good on the floor.
Listen, that Olivia Lane in the paint is going to give them problems. That pass is what got her wide open for the three.
Because, I mean, what do you key in on? You're either leaving that shooter open
or the paint.
You got to respect the size.
You got to. Big shot for her to be able to knock that down, because people are going to choose to guard the paint first because that's the easier shot.
If you miss that, it's okay, we'll give that shot. We'll stay inside.
We'll stay inside. Now they got to respect the shooter.
And a 4-point play extends the largest lead of the night for the Lopes on the road. They're unbeaten in conference play and trying to keep it that way tonight. They trailed into halftime, but a 12-4 run has continued to grow in this third quarter. Martin with it. Tough shot inside. Earl, second chance, finds an open spot for three off the mark. Thornton had a chance, but a whistle inside, and it's going to keep it on this end of the floor. It's been an 8-0 run for Grand Canyon, but they've won the third quarter 18-4.
You see Earl getting fired up. She's like, we are not going to keep letting them get these easy buckets. We're going to get us one and two.
You get a three, it's a single-digit deficit. Wernley trying to do that off the mark. And Holland pulls down the board. Wildcats 3-for-15 tonight from three. They are a team that shoot it pretty well, a respectable number from outside.
And Wildcats are getting out-rebounded right now, and that is their game. So they've got to get under there and rebound those and get those second chance points like they're used to getting.
Now the fouls piling up. And this is where Grand Canyon Sierra really didn't do a lot of. Into the half, they were just 2-for-4 from the free throw line in two quarters. Now they're starting to get to the strike. First one clatters around and pops out.
And Coach Goodenough said that, you know, she said this is a hot team and they're figuring out how to make it work for them and get wins off of it. So you can see the adjustment from the first half to the second half with GCU.
Good board from Rising. She'll try a three. Just missed it. Some close looks. Lopes, no reason not to take their time on this end of the floor. Just work the ball around. Final minute and a half of the third quarter. Lopes storming out of the halftime break. Holland driving, stops on a dime, boots it out. Simons three, short. And a full possession for both teams on that end of the floor. No points for GCU. Rising in transition, shot fake. Now lets it fly off the mark. Up and down these two teams go. Holland takes it coast to coast and finishes.
I mean, she is quick. Her and Nadia are two of the quickest ones on this team. I mean, even with their passes, their speed up and down the floor. Gotta contain that.
Along with 10 points. How about 5 boards, 3 assists as well. A foul away from the floor. Look at Nolan picked her up. Just taking it all the way. And Ole steps in, but that's too late at that point. This is a team also, too. I mean, we've been mentioning no Trinity San Antonio, no Tiara Brown as well. Those are two players that prior to their absence, they've played and started in every game.
They're averaging double digits, and the fact that they're missing them and still able to produce is super impressive.
It's a really physical game that we've seen. And it was Earl that had it inside. Osley was trying to get the hand in there to jar it free. She gets whistled for the foul.
GCU, they rank first in the WAC in bench points, so they're showing that right now with, you know, they're missing two key players and still able to next player up mentality.
How about that? You can go on the road. You remove two of your starting pieces, and just as a team, you approach that challenge. We got to get it done. I mean, however you do it, you got to make it happen.
And that's what you love to see in a team. And Wildcats are not, it's not off of them either. They just got to figure it out and adjust to this team's play right now.
Everybody in the WAC in action tonight. 10 on the timer. Floated underneath, denied by Martin.
And see now, and that's what I'm saying by you have to get in front of that pass. A player like that can't even let her catch it.
Evans gets it off. Osley had a chance. I thought Evans was going to hoist that from half court. That'll do it for the third quarter, and a third quarter that belonged to Grand Canyon. 10-point lead for the Lopes. Final quarter coming your way next on ESPN+.
WAC Vegas is back. The best fans, championship basketball, all in exciting Las Vegas. Join us March 13th through the 16th at the Orleans Arena for the 2024 Hercules Tires WAC Basketball Tournament. Don't miss the crowning of a men's and women's champion. For more information, go to WACSports.com/WACVegas.
Final quarter on the horizon. Let's take a look at the Wildcats' upcoming 5. They've got 2 nice home games in front of them before they hit the road, and it starts against Julie Goodenough's alma mater, UT Arlington, on January 20th. But trying to take advantage of the upcoming home games that they have. Now for the Lopes upcoming. They start tonight. What's a 3-game road trip before they go back home to Phoenix, but at Tarleton, at Utah Valley. Just back on those days of a lot of ground covered, a lot of plane rides, a lot of bus trips. It's all that includes elbow deep in conference play.
Absolutely. Going to have to make sure they get their rest on these road trips like that.
Tough to sleep on a bus or on a plane. It's not as easy as some people think sometimes.
I don't know. After games like this, I could just sleep through anything.
Whole conference in action tonight. Booted out Evans, and she walked with it. Turnover gives it back to ACU. And the Wildcat and Lopes men in action as well in Phoenix. It's a big one for Brett Tanner's bunch on the road. They start a three-game road trip tonight. That one's starting in about half an hour. It's going to be 7 o'clock Mountain Time over in Phoenix. Full slate of action between men's and women's hoops across the WAC tonight. Thornton with it with 10 on the timer. Floated to Martin. And a whistle on Lane as the two were fighting for position underneath. Mentioned Grand Canyon, what they've got to come. They're coming off of four games at home. They wrapped up the non-conference schedule against Arizona Christian, a resounding 115-41 win. And then Middle Tennessee State, 68-59. Martin underneath a power dribble off the window, no. And then a tie-up.
They're going to scrap for it every single time.
Every time. Every time. It'll stay on this end of the floor. Lane will defend the inbound as Thornton's got it. Lofted to Earl. A minute into the fourth quarter as Holland got a hand in there and batted it away.
They've got this lead and they are not going to let it go easy. So Wildcats are really going to have to get in here and make some major adjustments. Already seeing a big one from Martin. She was defending Lane down there on the other end.
Thornton, a nice finish. Almost lost her balance. Even drew Lane over with the outreached hand, but still got it to go. We're seeing the paint open up a bit, too, letting the guards crash in there. And so a whistle on this end of the floor. It'll come back to ACU.
And listen, Olivia Lane is 6 points away from 1,000 points, so she will most likely get that tonight the way she's been dominating the lane tonight.
She'll check out for now. Spent all of her time at North Dakota before coming over to Phoenix. Play for Coach Miller's bunch. Peyton, all a three, got it. Gotta think some threes are gonna go down if the Wildcats fight back in. It's a 5-point game.
And she loves the pressure. Like we said, she doesn't like an uncontested three, but you put a hand in her face and she is going to drain it.
And it's the two guards of who we saw in the first half with Hole and Thornton. Thornton knocked down the jumper to get the scoring started. And right here, Evans just gets lost. Maybe tried to sell the contact from Hole and was looking for it. You could see after. Just tried to hit the deck, but Hole took advantage of it.
I mean, listen, Evans has been moving 80,000 miles per hour since the game started, so she's probably getting a little tired. Those legs are turning into noodles. I mean, mine's wood.
8:20 to go in the fourth quarter. This is a ball game. It's a 5-point lead after AC. I mean, you start with a 10-point lead. There's another look from the Hole three. Got to get her going and some shots to go from outside. Peyton Hole has three of the four threes for ACU tonight. The other one belonging to Gracie Wernley back in the first half. It's a tough assignment with how we've seen Grand Canyon in the paint tonight. And so you got to try to limit the paint touches underneath. But three fouls for Erikstrup where she's sitting at and four for Lane. So you talk about how she's close to that milestone, but she heads to the bench in foul trouble.
Absolutely. And you know, if she's get close to the end, they might not need her back in. But, you know, because like we said, they have the next player up mentality. So we'll see if somebody else can step in and fill that role for now.
Wildcats tonight have gotten to the free throw line at a really good rate. Grand Canyon just 3-for-7 from the stripe. ACU, Sierra, 11-for-12. So you're going to see likely offensively a lot of guards crashing in this fourth quarter. And then looking to try to boot out and hit some open looks as well.
a 5-point game when it was just 10. I mean, they know how to adjust these both of these teams, and we can look for some of these players from ACU's bench to step up and match what GCU's bench is doing. It's going to be a close one regardless.
It's going to be close, yeah, and you can see the standings too, why this game matters. Grand Canyon at 4-0, ACU 2-1. One of the rare few teams, the only team, if you look at it, that hasn't played a fourth conference game. So that's what has them up at the top, in the top of the pack of the WAC. Utah Tech right there at 2-2 and 8-7 underneath ACU. The top eight get in. So, you know, we're talking about Grand Canyon missing some of their top pieces. All the more reason for ACU thinking, hey, we got to have this game.
Absolutely.
Grand Canyon racing out already to a 4-0 start. Right up there with California Baptist, top the WAC. Nice baseline
and
drive.
Again, with that skip pass. And with Eric Strip, you don't know if she's going to body you in the paint or she's going to knock down a three.
We talk about depth, too. They rotate lane out. Eric Strip back in. It's a tough force to try and fight with. Fano back in, who passes it up to Evans on the turnover. Eric Strup with the baseline lay-in makes it a 7-point lead. Evans gashing inside, elbow jumper no, and Traeger pulls down the board.
You know, she should got to knock down that open jumper like that because they were worried about Fano.
Boots it out to Thornton. Holland got a hand in there and knocked Thornton off balance. 10 on the shot clock for Traeger. Down to 5. Might have to force. As Thornton driving, lets it go and fouled with 1.8 on the shot clock. And if you're Molly Miller, those are the ones that just drive you nuts.
And everyone's moving so fast, you know, GCU players are shocked with getting this foul call, but you've got to stay in front. Once you get past and you start to swiping and putting the hand in, it's foul. Foul territory.
Thornton sinks the first. ACU 12 for 13 as a team tonight from the stripe. Around and out. Couldn't get them both down. A 6-point lead with 3 minutes gone in the final frame. Grand Canyon with out Brown and San Antonio, both their first team all-conference members, trying to piece it together tonight, and they've got the pieces to do it, especially inside as Eric Strupp again knifes through. No one saw her, no one picked her up.
I mean, listen, a 6-1 guard again. The way she just cut from the top of the lane all the way to the bottom, it's hard to knock her off.
Eight-point lead for the Lopes on the road and trying to protect that. Wildcats got a Peyton Hole three and an Aspen Thornton bucket to start the fourth quarter and immediately worked it to a 5-point lead. So some life for the Wildcats, a whistle underneath. How's the shoe game?
Listen, I was already paying attention because the whole squad got them.
Yeah, that's true. Thornton with it in the far corner. And pocket picked by Holland, just swatted the ball away. And now running, finds Evans in transition, yes.
Listen, I just commented, she's fast. She's going to be the first one, if not one of the two first ones down the floor every single time.
And who was the second but Evans? Just fast. When you're fast and you've got a teammate that's fast, you know you're going to run the floor and look for the other. Oh, looking for the back door. Earl with it. Now Martin to the floor. And a tie-up has the arrow to Grand Canyon. Molly Miller was trying for a timeout.
Everybody who's touched the floor tonight is definitely going to have at least one bruise.
I think Earl could have just kept that. I think she was more open than maybe she thought with Osley on the floor and tried to find Martin. It led to the tie-up. 5:45 in the fourth. It's a 10-point Grand Canyon lead.
knocked
away.
And you can see ACU has adjusted. You know, they've got Earl, I mean, they got Holland Hull right here in the paint to watch that backside because they throw that lob and Fano's right open.
So they'll get Bella Earl a break. Gracie Wernley into the action. Evans in the far corner. Back up top to Holland. 10 on the shot clock for the Lopes. Driving, Evans off the window was fouled. Evans, for just the first time tonight, is gonna head to the foul line. Simons is 1 for 2. Fano is 1 for 2, that's it.
And they are doing, Wildcats are doing a great job in denying that lane. Now, I love to see a team see the problem, fix the problem, and execute.
First one good for Evans. Second one for Evans is good. 65% free throw shooter, doesn't go to the line a lot. Really lives outside the perimeter. But she sinks them both. Oh, nice pass to Martin, has it swatted away. Really good bailout by Hull looking for Martin as she drew the pressure, got rid of it.
But she's Evans got to go up strong.
Yeah.
Especially with someone like Eric Strip on you, you've got to go up strong.
Traeger trying to save it. And it's to Evans on the floor. Traeger wanted to trap. Passing the halfway point in the fourth quarter as Thornton trying to draw the turnover, and she does. Hull on the run out. Takes it all the way and lays it in. And back to a 10-point game. That ends a scoring drought for ACU of over 2 minutes and stops a 6-0 run. Eric Strupp with it up high. Works around. Martin, the lone body inside the paint, now drawn out. Hard screen. Holland driving and finished.
Listen, big things come in small packages. That's my motto for her tonight.
Just wore the contact and was able to hang around, and now tying with 12. Lane and Eric Strupp also with 12. Hull for three, no. Holland pulls the board down, and a foul will send it the other way. Just the second team foul for ACU in the fourth quarter. Grand Canyon with 4. And Emma Troxel will sub in for a moment, but that's our media. So we'll step aside. A 12-point advantage for Grand Canyon, trying to close it down when we come back on ESPN+. One final time, returning to Moody Coliseum, and there's the next one up for the Wildcats as they welcome in the Lancers of California Baptist. This Saturday, it's a 1 o'clock central tip inside Moody Coliseum. Julie Goodenough excited for that one. She said it's the She Can Be Day. For more information, it's acusports.com. Holland up high, working the clock. Thornton wasn't giving her much space. Bono with it, got rid of it. Eric Strupp in front of the Lopes bench. Evans draws a slight double team. Back to Eric Strupp. 2 on the timer. Holland driving in. Too strong. Fano fighting for the board. And a foul on the rebound attempt. It's going to stay here.
And with a player like Fano in the paint, you're going to have to literally get in and get that fit in front of her and box her out.
I mean, it's the size, the depth at size that GCU possesses is really tough because right now without Lane and without Laura Eric Strip out on the floor, Sydney setting the high screen with Fano inside, it's very difficult to try and combat and keep fresh legs out on the floor. Evans with 2 on the baseline, floats it, no, and Troxel pulls down the board looking up Thornton with it. Wildcats don't have numbers. Thornton for three off the mark, no. And the board pulled down by Fano again.
And GCU's guards know exactly how to use these big body screens and just make plays with them. Well, they're doing it every set.
And then this right here is where Grand Canyon has nothing but time to burn. They'll take it down to 10 seconds every trip. Evans, a skip pass, finds Erikstra, and she stepped on the end line. Peyton Hull will come back in after a very short break. See if we can see it here. I don't think so, but that back foot, as Erikstra put it on the floor, that heel stepped out.
Got a lot of length to her.
Hull looking for Martin, fighting through, and a wild pass settled down by Fano. Lopes trying to make what time remains disappear with a 12-point lead. It's a team in GCU that averages about 68 points a night, so they're not far off that, but they really try and smother their opponents, holding teams to 54 points a contest.
So they're right on track right now with ACU at 48.
Four team fouls for both teams now. And so Holland will inbound. Both teams will be living at the free throw line for the final 2 minutes. Erikstra too strong underneath.
Listen, she is a force to reckon with.
Well, she spent most of the game having to watch from the bench. And she's got 14. It leads the team.
So you don't get her in foul trouble and you don't know what this game may look like.
6 for 9 from the field for Sydney Erikstra. 2 boards. And 2 for 4 from three as well. Those came early and definitely add to the total, but they've been huge. Addison Martin at the stripe, shooting 2. It's been a tough night. Tough night for Martin as Troxel pulls down the O board. Hull thought about a 3 and has it knocked off her thigh, and it's going to stay on this end of the floor. Thought that it was poked free by Holland and goes off the leg of Peyton Hull. Holland wants the crew to look at it. And now the officials will meet. They might. They're going to talk about it. Yeah, they'll look at it. I think this is going to go the other way just based off the real-time reaction, but we'll see. So this is to see if it was tipped by Holland, it goes off the leg of Hull, and then maybe if it was touched on the way out of bounds. But we'll see. I guess recapping this game for what we've seen, it feels closer than a 13-point lead for Grand Canyon, just with how close it was in the first half. But I think the third quarter was huge for Grand Canyon. They came right out. And how big was Olivia Lane in that third quarter?
I mean, she was a major presence. They figured out that they have size advantage over the Wildcats, and once they figured that out, they went with it and ran with it.
So Lane was battling foul trouble. She's on the bench with 4. And she is 6 points away from 1,000 career points. So maybe not tonight, as it doesn't look like she's in the huddle or anything like that, but very likely next game, which would be on the road, you can see Lane pass that milestone achievement.
Absolutely, I can see that for her. No hesitation.
But this is tough to see. I mean, you can see Holland get the hand out and it goes off the leg right there. I don't know, on the floor it was possession ACU. And so you can definitely see that it is deflected off of Hull's leg, but was it touched before? Probably. Was it touched after? You know, who knows?
Yeah, it's a hard call to see.
This might be our best look.
Yeah.
Great. Oh. There it's knocked. There's the leg.
It touches it.
And then does it go off anyone else? It goes off the
foot or no? Let's see it. it hits into her leg, and then it's, yeah.
I mean, you've seen that deflection, that result a million times, and you can tell it's tipped and then off the leg and then out of bounds. Should go the other way, but we'll see if the officials have seen enough to make that call. So nothing yet.
You hate to be an official making that call right now.
Yes. It's going to stay with ACU. So the Wildcats catch a break.
This is going to be big for them right here to score in this possession right under the basket.
A three makes it a 10-point game. They go right underneath to Martin, and she's fouled.
Listen, you have to make those buckets.
Those are the three-point plays you'd love to have. You mentioned it's been a tough night for Addison Martin. 3 points. The third just came at the free throw line her last trip.
It's been a scrappy night.
Around and out for Martin. Thornton and Hull have pulled a lot of the weight offensively. Second one for Martin is good, so she splits the pair. But where the Wildcats are normal, are used to seeing production from Bella Earl, it's been a tough night. Both her points coming from the stripe.
This would have been a great night for her to pull out one of those triple doubles.
Oh, yeah.
Definitely missing her production tonight on the offensive side.
It's kind of just it's a tip of the cap of what the Lopes can do. Or they force players out of rhythm. Troxel running the floor off the window, no. Good defense by Osley to run the floor. Whistle, they'll say a foul underneath. It'll stay on this end of the floor. Just over a minute to go in the final quarter, and the Wildcats seeing if they can chip away at what's a 12-point lead.
I mean, this game is flying by. I don't know if it's just us, but the way they've just been up and down, tip for tap, point for point.
This one from Martin is good. I think this fourth quarter has really slowed. We flew to halftime. And then the third quarter definitely seemed fast as well. But I think the physicality and the nature of the game wore off to some of the fans and some of the benches wanting more whistles, wanted less whistles. And a jump ball's gonna have it back with ACU. I think Molly Miller is saying, I was definitely calling for a timeout. I was begging for a timeout. And they're going to award a timeout to Grand Canyon. So with 1:09 to go, now the ACU bench has some questions that they'd like to be answered. But the Wildcats will huddle up, and the Lopes will now huddle up, so the possession arrow won't flip. It'll stay with ACU, and a timeout given to Grand Canyon.
Coach Goodenough really wants to defend this home court. You know, she says that they've been winning at home. They love to put on in front of their fans, so to drop a game right here is definitely gonna not sit well with her.
Well, and the two losses at home for ACU, you go back to Rice, a really good team out of the American, 69-58, so an 11-point loss. Holland will clear the timeline, gets it right out to Osley, and the Lopes will work it up top. 1 minute to go in the contest. And then the second one coming over the holiday break to Louisiana Tech, a team that is really hitting their stride. So definitely a team that has played opponents tough and played tough opponents at home. Three on the timer. Evans, tough drive. Batted around. Eric Strip knocked it out of bounds. And it'll go back to the Wildcats.
And And I don't know if they have seen, the Wildcats have seen size like this before, but if anything, what they'll take from this game is how to guard inside the paint.
Size, always tough to try and answer to. Thornton with a high screen. And a whistle on the screen. It's gonna go on Holland, who not long ago had one, now that's number three. Aspen Thornton a chance to work it to a single digit margin. Left the first one short.
Free throw misses in this game for the Wildcats could have put them in the game.
And that's 0 for 2 for Thornton on a team, as a team, now 16 for 22. Earl, a three that doesn't go. And a timeout from Molly Miller as the Lopes were looking to run with the timer, with the shot clock off, should say. So a timeout now to talk things over. Just a 30-second timeout. Kind of weird. Looked like the Lopes were going to run there, but they'll talk things over here for the final 25. For Grand Canyon, we talked about their road ahead. They're going to stay on the road. As with this win tonight, it'll move the Lopes to 5 W's in a row, living in that win column lately, and so they'll keep that right where they like it. They go to Tarleton to take on the Texans, and then heading out west to take on Utah Valley and Orem. That one's a week from tonight. 6 p.m. Mountain Time.
It's a way to start a road trip with a win.
Yeah.
That'll keep the momentum going.
Fresh off of a 73-48 win over the Trailblazers of Utah Tech. That, at the time, a Utah Tech team that was 2-1 in WAC play and 8-6 overall. First one for Eric Strupp around and goes down. Started the first quarter on a 19-3 run. Ended up with four starters in double figures. And so another timeout. Both teams going to huddle this one up. 12-point advantage for Grand Canyon. And I think size is the big word that we were impressed with tonight for the Lopes, the depth that they were able to show off to a team and a bunch knowing, hey, we're without some of our top two names that we can lean on a night. This is great experience for if you do come into foul trouble. They had that tonight, again, without those two names. How you can react when you're just throwing matchups and throwing five and working with the chemistry out on the floor. They did a great job with that tonight.
Absolutely, and Eric Strupp is one that really, you know, I'm not going to say she shocked me because you can expect,
right,
you know, what she's doing. But out on the perimeter, I didn't expect a shooter like that.
Points in the paint, 38-22 tonight for GCU as Thornton finds Martin. Troxel calling for the open three. Got it. And pressure on the inbounds pass. A timeout taken by Miller. Just the fifth three of the season knocked down by Troxel. And that makes it a 9-point lead. Almost like both teams trying to see if GCU can make this a 10-point win or more, or ACU trying to shave off as many as they can. It's now 9.
Yeah, they say, hey, if we are going to take this L,
we're going to fight.
We're going to fight. Yeah. Y'all are going to have to take this one.
Tonight for GCU, they had 6 different shooters finish with 6 shots to go, I should say 3 different shooters with 6 shots to go down from the floor. And they're all the bigs. Lane with 6. Jada Holland with 6. Not a big, but how many times have we seen her downhill driving to the lane? She goes 6 for 13 tonight.
Wow.
In almost 40 minutes.
She's She is not a big, but she definitely plays like a big.
Yeah.
I mean, she's getting boards. She's driving into the lane with not a blink of an eye. She's not even threatening to go in there.
7 boards and 6 assists. So the driving too, but then able to get rid of it. And then we see Sydney Ehrenstrup with 16 points in limited time, only 21 minutes.
Listen, I can't tell them two apart.
Sydney and Laura for GCU. Across half court and a whistle as Thornton was trying to get the offensive. So that will send Holland to the line, a chance to extend what's been 12 points for her. No free throws for Holland tonight. And she'll change that with 9 seconds to go in the ball game. First one is too strong. And then for ACU, you got to tip your cap to Peyton Hull, a game high 19, 4 boards, had an assist in there. Bella Earl, we mentioned she didn't have really the usage that ACU's accustomed to, but still able to pull down 6 boards and pick up 2 assists and 2 shots to go in at the free throw line. And then you've got Aspen Thornton, 5 for 9 at the free throw line and finishes with 15. And Thornton now, with the clock winding down, lets one go from 3 off the mark, and that will do it. A final this Thursday night from Moody Coliseum. Grand Canyon with their 5th consecutive win. They take down the Wildcats inside Moody, 64-55, your final score. It's just a good game, tight in the first half, but I think the difference we saw in the third quarter, Grand Canyon came out and looked like a different team out of the locker room.
It absolutely did. She must have put some fire under their behinds in that locker room, and they came out and got it together. Wildcats definitely going to need Bella Earl to show up in that next game, because we see that in the WAC, they can't afford for her tonight.
20-8, Grand Canyon outscores ACU in the third quarter, their 5th consecutive win. That'll do it. This has been a presentation of the Western Athletic Conference on ESPN+. For our entire crew, Sierra Henry, I'm Chris Jarrett saying so long from Abilene, Texas.